So Donald Trump did one of the most despicable things I think he's ever done since I've known of him, and that's saying something. Donald Trump decided to visit Arlington National Cemetery. Now, as an American citizen, he can go. He's more than welcome to. But he went to a grave of one of the 13 service members that were killed on the raid, or on the evacuation and leaving of Afghanistan. The reason I say it's one of the most despicable things I've ever seen is because Donald Trump is directly responsible for that service member dying. Oh, I'm sorry. Did you think I was going to say Biden? No. See, Donald Trump screwed that up from moment one. We had a government installed in Afghanistan. We did. But Donald Trump did negotiate with the Afghan government. He negotiated with the Taliban. You remember the people that we had been fighting all this time in that country? What the fuck? Did y'all think we were only fighting Al-Qaeda? Who was protecting Al-Qaeda? The Taliban. He negotiated directly with them. Directly. Did not even have the Afghan government at the table. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to keep reminding you of this. He wanted to meet with the Taliban at Camp David on September 11th. Yeah. He did that. Yeah. And the Taliban gave him a list of things they wanted, and he gave it to them. All of them. Every one of them. Including releasing 5,000 Taliban and Al-Qaeda fighters back to the Taliban. One of the people that he released is now the leader of the Taliban and therefore the leader of Afghanistan. He negotiated this so fucking poorly that it was bound to fail. And then he lost the election. And he made it worse. He tied the hands of the incoming Biden administration. And they had to follow through on the shit that he promised. Which resulted in the death of 13 service members, 11 Marines, one Navy corpsman, and a staff sergeant from the United States Army. So here he is, posing with the family of this service member, this fallen service member, while giving a thumbs up. Let me tell you why this is one of the most despicable things that Donald Trump has ever done. In addition to everything I just told you, let's look at Donald Trump's history. Donald Trump never served in the United States military. Not one time. No member of the Trump family has ever served in the military. Not one. Not those ugly ass sons of his, and I'm not talking about Barron, nor his daughters. No member of the Trump family has ever served in the military. He got deferments for bone spurs so that he would not have to go to Vietnam. This is an absolute truth. Then, in a Playboy magazine article or interview, he said that dodging STDs in college was his own Vietnam. I wonder why there's so many Vietnam vets that support this man. How many more times does a guy have to pee in your face before you realize it's not rain, it's urine? According to General John Kelly, who was his chief of staff, Donald Trump went to France on the celebration of World War II and wouldn't get out of the car because it was raining and he didn't want his hair wet. And then, when he actually did go, he was forced to. When he did go to the graves of some of the service members that died in France, he asked, why did they do it? Why did they do it? Why did they do it? Then he proceeds to call these people suckers and losers. This is the same man that said that the former chief of staff, the former head of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, should be tried for treason. Why did he say this? Because General Milley, who was the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, called his counterpart in China to assure them that democracy is going to go through and everything will be fine. When did he call him? January 6th of 2021. when the world watched as Donald Trump supporters tried to take over the Capitol to stop the certification of an election that was duly held with no bullshit, except for when Republicans got caught voting twice, but I digress. And he did it at the behest of people within the Trump administration. But General Milley should be tried for treason. The same story I told the other day about Donald Trump saying that never let a disabled veteran sing in front of people at a ceremony for General Milley, who was retiring at the time, because nobody wants to see that. And yet, with all of that, the same people that will stand in my face and thank me for my service will vote for a man who has disrespected myself and every other person who's ever wore the uniform, past, present, or future, over and over again. The same man that said that John McCain wasn't a war hero because he likes his war heroes who don't get captured, who felt so bad because John McCain crashed his fucking little party about his healthcare benefits or healthcare plan, that he had people put tarps over the USS John McCain because he did not want to see it. Quick question off the top of your head. How many military bases has Donald Trump visited? He's the president of the United States. He can go whenever he wants. W did it. Obama did it. Biden has done a couple. Herbert did it. Reagan did it. How many military bases did Donald Trump visit as president of the United States in the 4 years he was there? The same man that went to North Korea to negotiate peace and fell in love, I guess, and try to get them to stop their nuclear program, only for Kim Jong-un to laugh in his fucking face and continue missile testing right after he left. And he only stopped military exercises between the South Korean military and our military, joint exercises that have been going on longer than Donald Trump even thought about being president. This man disrespects the people in uniform every single solitary day, and yet for some reason, people just act like they don't know that he's doing it, or try to explain it away. What he meant was, he took a photo op at the grave of a fallen serviceman. He did that. Because all of it is a photo op for him. That's all it is. Donald Trump is using men and women who had the fortitude to do something no member of his bloodline has ever done as a photo op. And so many of you who served and who are currently serving find that to be inspirational. I find it to be downright disrespectful. But I forgot, I was in combat arms because I was in supply and I went to Afghanistan. Yeah, that's how y'all sleep at night. By turning this into, well, real combat arms people understand Trump as opposed to support. As if those combat arms guys could do anything without support. Donald Trump is continually pissing in the faces of active duty, National Guard, Reserve, and veterans. And so many of you are getting cups thinking it's rainwater and drinking it down. And you have the nerve to question me about my service. Who's betraying their oath by supporting a man who didn't give a shit about it in the first place?